Netflix Brand Story. Hello and welcome to What a Brand. Today we are about to share a very special brand story with you. Any guesses? Spoiler alert, it is in the title. Yes, we are going to tell you the brand story of Netflix. How Netflix became what it is today. Thank you. Moving on to the facts now. Did you know that the Netflix founder, Reed Hastings, came up with the idea for the DVD by mail rental business because he was late returning a videotape? I mean, in the mid-90s, back in the video home system days, Reed Hastings was said to have rented the movie Apollo 13 from his local Blow CK Buster video store and couldn't return it on time. He was charged a late fee of $40 and obviously he was quite embarrassed about it. But it also got him thinking that there could be a huge market out there for a movie rental business by mail. So he started to work on this idea and later came to know about DVDs from one of his friends. The advent of the DVD held hours of video and could be delivered cheaply. Now this presented the perfect opportunity. So what he did was he bought a few DVDs from a store and mailed them to himself to check if this model would work well. And to his surprise, he found out that it worked perfectly fine. Then Netflix began renting DVD rentals by mail in 1998 and introduced its subscription model the following year. And nearly a decade later, Netflix started streaming video, and that, my friends, has revolutionized the way we watch television. Thank you for watching this video. You know how the company Google got its name? Well, you are about to find out. Larry Page and Sergey Brin were the two people who had a startup which was initially called Backrub. Then in 1997, post a brainstorming session, they decided to change the name of their startup. They wanted to come up with a name that would evoke the amount of data they were indexing. The name Googleplex came up in the meeting and Page countered with the shorter Google, which denoted the digit 1 followed by 100 zeros. When an employee checked to see if that domain name was taken, he accidentally searched for Google.com instead of Google.com. Page liked the name Google even better and registered the domain name for Brin and himself. So yes, one of the biggest brands in the world today gets its name from a simple typing error. Thank you for watching this video.